6 of those. Hello, this is Emma. Welcome. Do you remember the nail polishes I got a few weeks ago from the chemist, from the drugstore? Well, I thought that tonight we could test them out. I've got some most importantly. Tea? Nice English copper. Milk in last, and you'll see soon. I'm going to move the camera down. All the polishes, and a nice wooden surface to test them. Know what these are? Can you guess? Lots of these. Salon testers. Going to paint the polish onto these nails. They come with a ring like this. You pop them on. That. So let's move the camera down towards the table, and you can everything nice and close. All right, enjoy. I love these olive wood boards. Soft. This one, round one, and one. Lovely. So, to refresh your memory, here are the polishes. We have two. Full price. very I believe that's it. The rose tinted collection. And then this one, which is the colour I have on today. It's another barrier. And six of those. Sally Hansen ones. Okay. So let's test them out. Okay. Pop them over here. Let's go for the polish I'm wearing tonight. It's called, let's see, Carnation, and it's by the Barium Jelly High Shine Collection. So this one is quite a raspberry colour. It has some shine to it, just a little. These plastic nails can take quite a bit, and we want the colour to be solid so you can see. I'll leave them to dry on the olive wood. So see it on my nails. eyes colour, I tend to go for the solid matte colours. But this one has a little disco to it. And it's not too much. I do like glittery polishes sometimes, but I haven't worn yet, but I will, and it's called Huckleberry, and again, Jelly Eyeshine from Berry M, and it's a dusty blue, I'd say. On the light, I think. Let's take a look. Looks a little lighter and more blue. To me, it's slightly darker. And I'd say it's actually quite a classic colour. And not too much. Solid colour, and with lots of layers, could be nice and dark. So an unusual colour to choose. And it's not dissimilar to other colours I have, one of them being vintage violet. It's very close actually, perhaps a little more pinky, less purpley. It's a very pretty colour, vintage violet. My favourite Berry M colour, but I haven't seen it for a while. Not that I've been shopping very often, but whenever I've seen the Berry M shelf, the classic colours aren't really there at the moment. So this one, it's more like a dusty pink, then a purple. It's really nice. Just placing it on for you. Hibiscus. That's one of my favorites, I think, from this selection. I'll try the last barrier from the sale selection, and then I think we'll move on to the Sally Hansen, and then the two rows. There's a hint, just a hint, of salmon colour too, in different light, mostly orange, and I do like it. It's quite summery, spring summer. It's not too bright. Nice deep colour. I think if it was darker, I'd say it's more of an autumn. And this could still be autumn, but it's quite cheerful. So I think it would work in the summer too. It's pretty, isn't it? And again, it's darker for me. Talking of salmon, quite peachy, salmon-y sort of toned. So let's have a look. Let's have a look first at the 70. Sally Hansen, and it's 156 raising the bar. And it needs quite a lot get a solid colour. It somehow looks less 70s out of the bottle. It's quite pretty. A little shine to it. Not too much. Again, this is more grey out of the bottle, slightly. That's the dusty element I talk of, the amount of grey in it. Again, less shiny of the bottle, more of a solid colour, and I do like it. It's sort of a grey purple. Yeah. So, in the bottle, you can really see the two-tone element. Just very delicate there. Let's have a look at this mysterious corally peachy colour. Let's see. Looks different out of the bottle as well. So this one as well, I can point out that as it dries, it becomes more bronze. I'm noticing more bronze and less coffee. It's against the burnt orange. This one looks more red now. Interesting. It's like a vintage orange. And I'm glad that I found all these polishes in the sale, because I think actually some of the mug colours I wouldn't have pretty. We have two more here, and those are for the rose. So we have French rose, and I had this on the other day, and this one is called Crushed. It's not dissimilar to this one, a little lighter. And I love the way that these colours go on there, just nice and thick. And I normally just have two coats of Berry Hymn colours. And the bottles a very long time. There. It's just lighter, isn't it? What do you think? There's a little bit sticking out on this nail. Just on the corner, a little bit of plastic sticking. Really nice, isn't it? A nice spring summer colour again, but actually I just think these dusty colours are suitable for most of the year. It's a classic, aren't they? Vintage colours. Lovely. That one. Let's put the particularly handsome ones. These are the two rose tinted. Very pretty. They could obviously do with some gloss over the top coat. But they're still pretty shiny as they are. Tell me which you prefer. Here we are. Hope you enjoyed looking at those colours. And now it's time to fall fast asleep. Goodnight. Goodnight. Sleep well. Sweet dreams. Goodnight.